I've also seen people not have so many degrees, but had fantastic attitude. You know, there were people who are willing to learn all the time. There were people who are willing to respect and do what is expected from them. People who are highly motivated or not learning. And therefore, that attitude, you know, see, when you have a good attitude, you don't need attitude. When you want to sell a product, you need good attitude. You don't have put an attitude. But when you have your attitude requires money. Right? You have a good attitude, it shows. You have a bad attitude, it shows. Right? And people are attracted to good attitude. You have a good attitude and you know what you need to be doing in your job, you will automatically.
Another question is, what is the great successful job and start
their own business? Good question. Three sides. So I was doing pretty well in my job.
You know, chief distribution excellence office of Tata company was good, and I just but I decided that, you know, what is my purpose? I understood what my purpose was. And my purpose is really to inspire people. My purpose is to help people identify their potential. And therefore, once they identify their potential, they can convert it into performance. See, I want to tell you that all of you who are watching here, each of you have a very unique purpose. No, not some of you will become engineers, some will be doctors, some will be software, some will be musicians, some will be philosophers, some will be IA officers, right? Different. Each one has got a unique purpose. So the moment you identify what your purpose is and you engage with your purpose, for me, my purpose was to help people identify their potential. And when I said, I'm going to do that, right? I'm going to focus all my time doing that. It gave me a lot of satisfaction. And I tell you, in life, what matters at the end of the day is satisfaction. Satisfaction is something that money cannot buy. And satisfaction happens only when you do what you are created to do. God has created each of you to do something specific. And when you find that specific thing and you do it, oh, you'll be really satisfied. So I think for me, I found my calling, my purpose, which was to inspire people. So I do that as a job. I've run my own business. So I teach. I'm a leadership coach. I teach senior CEOs and top level management, middle level management. I coach people on how can they become better and use their potential. And that gives me a lot of joy and satisfaction. So that's the reason why I took that, Mithai.
Thanks, sir. What is purpose and how can one identify one's purpose, sir?
Okay, purpose is the why of you. It's the why of you, right? Let's say you're a manufacturer and you decide to manufacture a car. Okay, you design the car in terms of what length should the car be, what is the breadth, the width of the car, what is the specifications of the car, what engine you will use. And as a manufacturer, you have decided and said, okay, I'm going to create this thing like this so that it will go at top speed of this, it will have so much of comfort. It will be able to get people from one location to another very comfortably. So the manufacturer has a design idea, right? And I think that I'm a builder of God. God is our manufacturer, right? In a sense. And he has a design idea for each of us. He has a design idea for you, for everybody else on the call. He's got a specific design idea. And that is your purpose. That's the why of you, right? The reason I believe I'm alive right now, it's because I have purpose to finish. I need to complete that purpose, right? So each of us have purpose. Now, the way to identify your purpose is by understanding what are your talents, right? Some are talented in putting things together. Some are talented in drawing. Some are talented in remembering a lot of things. Some are talented in, they have an interest towards medicine and things like that, right? So that's there. For example, one of my favorite musicians is A.R. Rahman. Favorite. He's called the Mozart of Madras, right? Favorite musicians, right? I just like it. Yeah. So I was saying, I was talking about ARM. I really like his work, his quality of work, his excellence, and the fact that he identified what his purpose. His purpose is to make music. And he said, I'm going to do only music. Right? So when you identify your purpose and you do it, you will be very successful. Right? So a way to identify your purpose is to identify your talents. Right? So find your talents, you'll find your purpose.
So what is the difference between talent and a gift, sir?
Okay. See, talent is in its raw form. Okay, talent is in its raw form. So you may have a talent of music, right? And all of us on the call right now have some talent or the other. All of us have some talent. But when you work on that talent, you put effort, you give effort, you keep working, then you get better at it. Then you keep working some more, then you get good at it. And then you keep working some more, you get, your talent gets converted to a gift. You see, Roger Federer as a tennis player, when he started as a young kid, he knew he was good at it. So he kept practicing. But you know, it took years of practice. It took years of effort. It took experience and persistence to convert that talent into a gift. Now, we all have talents. And we all have an equal opportunity to convert it into a gift. A talent won't become a gift by itself. For it to become a gift, it requires effort. It requires belief. Or let me put it this way. It requires belief first. It requires effort. And it requires focus. So when you get belief, effort, and focus, when you put it together and you keep practicing it, then your talent becomes a gift. Now, there are many people who were very talented. But unfortunately, they did not convert it into a gift. So convert the talent into a gift.
Thanks for answering my question, sir. Can you give some advice for our students, sir?
Advice would be understand that you are unique. All are different. You see the five fingers, all the five fingers are different. One of the fingers are same. Now, each of us across the planet Earth have unique fingerprints, very unique fingerprints, unique DNA, right? Unique iris in the eye. It's unique. Why is it different? Why is it unique? It's unique to tell us that you are created unique. So understand your individuality. Don't try to be somebody else. Be yourself. Your secret to success is by being yourself and not trying to copy to be somebody else. Okay? So first advice is be yourself. Second advice is believe in yourself. You have to believe that what your strengths are. Now, you have strengths, you'll have weaknesses. That's fine. But believe in your strengths. If you don't believe in yourself, you cannot expect others to believe in you. Right? So believe in yourself. Believe that you got a plan, you got a purpose, you can actually achieve, provided you're willing to put the effort. So, yeah, so be yourself, believe in yourself, and become all that you can become. You got potential within you. Unless you identify that potential and work on that potential, you can what you want to be. The only thing we can automatically grow is, you can grow old automatically, but you can't grow successful automatically. Success is a process, right? Which means you got to work at it, you got to use your talents, and you got to keep practicing, right? So these are three things I'll tell you, Mutai. Be yourself, believe in yourself, and become all that you're supposed to be.
Thank you, sir. Now I hand it over to our students to ask questions, sir.
Sure.
Rajiv, before that, you have any questions for the students, please?
I think my only question is to try and ask them, how are you using the online platform? How are you using the time, the COVID time, to further your dreams and studies? How are you using that?
Yeah, anyone who can answer to Mr. Rajiv can come forward and tell. How are you doing your COVID online studies? Anyone can come forward.
Hello, sir.
Yeah, go ahead.
So, as the online classes are not like school, but now this year we are teaching exam. I want to appreciate our management to organize online classes. If they don't organize online classes, if we don't know anything, how can we write for big sir? So I thank our teachers and management for organizing online classes. As you asked, scheduled, it's normal, sir. As we read Fajr Namaz, we used to wake up earlier. And after praying Fajr Namaz, we used to revise poetry yesterday. And so we used to and we had classes in the AM. It's as we, it's like half school, sir.
Very good.
Not different.
Very good. Abdul, this is Abdul Wahab School, right?
Yeah, exactly.
Is he on call? Is Abdul Wahab?
No. The management is very far from all this. Okay. They don't have
A lot Abdul, of Abdul Wahab and me used to go for together, friends. I've not been in touch with him for a long time. Abdul Wahab, his elder brother, Zakir, right?
Yeah, exactly.
Zakir,
eldest one is Shamim Bhai, who expired a few years back.
Okay. So you have Zakir, you have Abdul Wahab, and one more brother there, younger brother.
There are, I think, 6 to 7. Khalil sir, can you just tell the names of the brothers?
Shamim sir, who expired. Then Tamim sahab is there, second. Then Zakir sahab. Mm-hmm. Next Abdul Wahab sahab. Ashraf Ali sahab.
Ashraf, correct.
So total 6.
Yeah.
6 is
there. Yeah. Okay, fine.
And how is your father Hashim sahab?
Allah, he is fine, sir. Alhamdulillah. He is doing good.
Yeah. Okay, Anil sir, what about the online classes which Rajiv sir asked? Any feedback on that from the teacher's perspective and the student's perspective?
Alhamdulillah, from teacher's side, teachers are taking much efforts to make it success. But the ground reality, 50 to 60% of the students are attending. So overall, if we see here, different reasons for not attending classes and all. So we are planning to achieve 100% giving chapters. Alhamdulillah.
Good. Very good. So is this Ambur or what?
Mail Visharam, nearby Arcot.
Arcot, correct.
Yeah.
It's exactly 30 kilometers from Velo.
Hi,
Yeah, okay. So, Sahib, any questions which has come on the chat box?
I'm ready, sir. So, this question is asked by Esther. This is a good platform. Can you give us some advice? This question is asked by Edstam, sir.
Could you repeat the question, please?
Is YouTube a good platform? It takes too much time to get successful. Can you give us some advice?
See, I think the success is, there's nothing called as overnight success. Okay, you can't take the lift to be successful. You have to climb the stairs to be successful. Right? So, but I think you must look at following a success routine, right? So how do you spend your day every day? What are the things that you do, right? Do you spend time to feed your mind, which means do you read, feeding your mind, very important, right? Second is, do you exercise, physical exercise, again, very important, right? The reduced physical exercise. Because our health is very important. If you don't have health, you cannot be successful. Finally, your habits in terms of eating. I think that's again, are you eating right? Then what else, how are you spending your time? See, end of the day, it is about what are you spending your time for? The definition of is time for things. If you don't exchange your time for the right reasons, then you cannot be successful. Now, you may say, I want to just relax. If you're relaxing all the day, and that means you're exchanging your time for relaxation only. I'm not saying you should not relax. It's important to relax. But if you exchange your time only for relaxation, then you cannot be successful. If you're exchanging your time for all the time being on the internet, you can't be successful. There is a time. So, what are you exchanging your time for? What is your success routine? Are you feeding your mind the right thing? Are you physically fit? I think all these factors will come. And what are your goals? If you don't have goals in life, now many of you are in 10th standard. Now, your goal should not be only to get a good percentage in 10th standard. It's a good goal to have. Then it's very short term. You must say that my goal is to become, for example, I want to be an engineer, I want to be a doctor, I want to do economics, whatever your goal is, right? I want to get into this college and I want to, you know, that's my goal. To get into that college, I need to be doing the following things, right? For that, what should I do now in 10th standard? What should I do? What should I do today? So having a goal and working backwards is also important.
So Abdurrahman, sir, sorry for... 1 minute. So one more KH group brothers, we have Hashim Sahib sons. So Janab Maulana Ibrahim Sahib.
Ibrahim Sahib.
Yeah, I think a son studying here itself, 10th Hassan. Okay, totally six. No, sir.
Okay.
Okay, fine.
Thank you.
You can go ahead, sir.
Okay, Mutahir, you can ask the next question.
Okay, sir. The next question is asked by Faizan Muhammad. As sir said, after the practices, the talent changed into gift, even though we didn't achieve our goal. That's what we have to do. We will get demotivated at the time. We have to quit or we have to work more.
See, a point is, life is about growing. Okay? And the way you grow through your experiences. Okay? Now, sometimes you may achieve what goals you set for yourself. Is very good. But there are times you don't achieve your goal the way you want it. But you must learn from the experience. You must have heard of the story of Abraham Lincoln, I think it was, right? He didn't succeed overnight. He had to go through so many failures before he became the president of America. So similarly, the person who discovered the light bulb, right? He took more than 900 attempts to discover the light bulb. 900 attempts, right? So, does it mean they failed? No, they didn't fail. They got rich by the experience. So, please don't think failure is a bad word. In fact, I'll be very worried with people who have not failed. Mm-hmm. Because people who have not failed mean that they have not learned. They have not taken a risk. They have not decided to go outside the comfort zone. They've been playing it safe. Right? So, failure is a learning opportunity. So, that's when you learn. You learn more from attempts that didn't work out compared to attempts that did work. Right? So, don't get demotivated, but you have to learn from it. What is that attempt which didn't go right? What did it teach me? What have I learned from it? As long as you're learning the lessons from attempts that didn't go right, you are growing. Mm-hmm. Okay, but don't get demotivated. It's pointless to get demotivated, right? What you'll get demotivated and do what? Quit, right? So that's not. You have to understand there is no concept of overnight success. I'm sure that A.R. Rahman himself, right, he didn't get successful the first attempt. He went to music producers and kept asking for chances. Nobody gave him chances initially, right? But after how many years? Today, he's known across the globe. He's won India an Oscar award. Did it happen easily? No. After many attempts of not working out, it finally began working out. Therefore, the one who wins is the one who never gives up. Remember that. The one who wins is the one who never gives up. Anybody can give up, but the winner never gives up.
Next question is asked by Masood Nawaz. How did you find your talent?
I found it because I took opportunities, right? I realized that I seem to like to speak. I like to speak in public. I liked to speak. I tried it once. I tried it second time. People said, hey, you're doing a good job. You can try this. So I got some encouragement and I kept doing it. And the more I did it, the more I realized I liked it. I liked it. I started to enjoy it. And I said, hey, if I do this, I'm enjoying. So let me do more of it. So I kept speaking more and more and more. And today, by God's grace, today is my fourth meeting after your call. I have another meeting at 5 o'clock and then I have another meeting at 7:30, right? So my days are packed like that. So I think I found it by enjoyment. I found it by encouragement. And I said, let me just do it. If I like it, do it. And so somebody said, if you do what you love, you'll end up loving what you do. That's how you'll be successful.
Thank you, sir. The next question is asked by Asif Muhammad. Who is your role model, sir?
Okay. A couple of people. There's John C. Maxwell. He's a leadership coach. He is my role model. I mean, I like the way he writes. I like another person called Simon Sinek. Again, he's a leadership coach, leadership guru. I like him. I like the Lord Jesus Christ. He's another role model of mine. In sport, I like MS Dhoni because he's calm, composed, great leader. So you can find out all the names I told you are all leaders, right? So, and since I teach a lot about leadership and I speak a lot about leadership, I find my role models from this set of people.
Okay, so this question is asked by Hamdan Rashid. Which education field you like so much?
Which education field?
Yeah.
Okay. Of late, I've begun to like psychology a lot. I didn't study psychology, but since I'm doing a lot of coaching and things like that, I started to develop an interest in psychology. Because psychology has got a lot to do with the mind. And at the end of the day, you know, we are what our mind is. The quality of our life depends upon the quality of our thinking. Remember this, the quality of our life depends upon the quality of our thinking. So what goes on inside our mind will determine our external world. And therefore, you know, since I do a lot of work on the mind, I started to like the field of psychology now. I like leadership and I like psychology. Two lines I like.
Okay, sir. This question is asked by Habibur Rahman. I started a YouTube channel, but I didn't have time to upload any videos. My surroundings distracting me what I want to motivate me to upload videos, sir.
So let me get the question right. He started a channel, but he could not upload videos, is what he said, right? Because of many reasons. Distraction.
Yeah.
Yeah, I think it's important that when you're starting a channel, you must be very clear about why you're starting it. What is the kind of content you want to put up there, right? So if your content is maybe, so for me, if you look at my YouTube channel, my content is on leadership. My content is on faith. My content is on inspiration. So that's what I want to be doing, right? So, and therefore that's number one, be clear about the content. Second is be consistent about the content. Make sure that you're putting up content at regular frequency, whether every week, or every 10 days, whatever your frequency is, be consistent. Be clear, be consistent, and make sure that there is some level of quality in your content. you know, if your content does not give quality, that means it's not creating value. And when it's not creating value, then people won't watch it, right? But I think we live in a time and age where we've got so many social media platforms to express yourself and express your ideas. Take advantage of it, make use of it. Your mobile phone is a great tool to actually record videos. Today's smartphones are quite good. The camera quality is quite good. So get that, get yourself a small mic. A mic is typically about 2,000 to 3,000 rupees. Get yourself a mic if you can and record.
The next question is asked by Ehsan Irbas. What was the thing that inspired you to become a great person?
I don't know whether I'm great, but I think what inspired me was I identified my purpose. And my purpose was to help others to identify their potential. So I started to enjoy it. And when I started to see that people were benefiting out of it, I continued to do that. And I think that is, it's in a sense, it's made me feel nice about what I do. And it's also helping others. So I guess it's a win-win for both, win for me and win for others. So I just continued to do that. And I said, let me write a few books. I wrote a few books. Let me put up content on YouTube or on Facebook. And I'm doing that. And as a profession, let me tie up with organizations and help them. So I'm doing that. Yeah. So that's what's kept me going so far.
Okay. So the next question is asked by Ismail Zabiullah. So personality really matters upon success. So can you tell me about personality? Like personality really matters upon success?
See, I think it's important to get the right definition of personality. You know, we have a wrong English language can be a little funny at times. Sometimes we think personality means I need to look like a Bollywood star or I need to look like a Hollywood star. That's a wrong definition of personality, right? Personality really is the person, who you are as a person, right? So if I have the right attitude, if I'm honest, if I'm respectful, if I keep my word, if I'm solution-minded, I can find solutions for people's problems. That is a great personality. Okay, so personality is really who you are. Remember that your character is your personality. So you have good character, and that means you got a good personality. Having said that, I think it's important how you dress. I think it's important hygiene, right? In a corporate setting, I'm saying, in an office setting, how you carry yourself, right? That personal hygiene and the way you dress, all that is important. But you don't have to look like Arnold Schwarzenegger, or you don't have to be a Hrithik Roshan or a Salman Khan looks. Yeah, if you look like Salman Khan, very good for you. But even if you don't look like Salman Khan, that's great. Your personality is inside of you. As long as your inside is clear, that's what matters.
Okay, sir. This question is asked by Edisham. My friend has a good talent in YouTube, but because of his parents, he stopped his career in YouTube. What should we do in this situation?
I think it's important to look at what your priorities are. Okay, if you are in a important age, let's say you're 10th standard, 11th and 12th, or even 9th, your top priority is to be focusing on studies. Allocate some time for your hobbies. It should not be the other way around, where I'm allocating all my time to hobbies and some time to studies, right? So prioritization is very important. I think it's important to even have a conversation with your parents and tell them that I understand the focus. My focus is to study and I'm going to be studying, right? And you prove it to them you're studying. But also tell them that I want to pursue a hobby and I'm allocating on an everyday basis, whatever, 1 hour, half an hour, whatever, or in a week I'm going to allocate 2 hours, whatever, right? So have that honest conversation. Do your part in terms of studies, right? And then you use the time which you plan for your hobby, they will be fine with it. The problem is if you focus all your time on your hobby, especially when you're in a critical year, of studies, and you spend very little time on studies, then you will fail. Somebody told me this: experience is a comb which a man gets when he has no hair. Experience is a comb which a man gets when he has no hair. What does that mean? It means that we get the understanding when it's too late, right? Sometimes I think, oh, I wish I can go back to school. I go back to school, those years I didn't study properly. No, I wish I can go study well now. Then maybe I could have become a doctor. But that it's too late for me now, right? Now you are the right time. At the right time, if you get that insight and say, okay, now is what I should be doing, this. I want to pursue my hobby, but my main thing is studies. If you have that kind of understanding, that's great.
Okay, so the next question is asked by Umer. How should we know our talent?
How should we know our talent? Yeah, like I answered a little while earlier, look at those areas which you enjoy doing. What are those areas that you enjoy doing, right? And those areas should be good, not bad, right? What are those areas when you do, others are benefited? For example, if you're a good speaker, when you speak, others are benefited. If you're numbers, you like numbers, right? You do it, you enjoy it, and others also are blessed by it, right? So what are those, if it's singing, you enjoy it, others like, wow, please sing another song, yeah, Mutayyab. I really like you. When you sing, you know, my mind is very calm, right? So you know you're blessing others. So look at those. That's a very easy way to find your talents. What do you enjoy to do? And what do others are blessed by what you do? And most importantly, you can do it free. And you can do it, if they wake you up from your sleep also, you don't mind doing it. What are those areas, right? For example, I told you, my first call today was at 6:30 in the morning. My second call was, 7 o'clock in the morning. My second call was from 9:30 to 1:15. Now I'm doing this call. I have another call at 5. I have a call at 7:30. Now, I should be tired, but I'm not tired because I like doing what I'm doing. Right? And I'm talking to different groups. Now, I'm talking to a school here. I'm talking to very senior government officials at 5 o'clock. So I enjoy doing it. And therefore, it's my talent. So I like to do it. So what do you enjoy doing? What will others be blessed? What do you don't get tired of at all? That will be your talent.
Okay, so the next question is asked by Hamdan Rashid. Which thing you considered as failure in your life?
Sorry, which thing I consider as failure?
Yes, sir.
I don't consider anything as failure in my life. And that's a very honest answer. Are there parts of my life I'm a little disappointed? Maybe I'm disappointed, but I wouldn't consider it as a failure, right? So I told you there were a few years I kind of did, I were not focused on. I went all out to have fun. Maybe I could have used that time much better. Like I told you, life is always measured by how did you use your time? Remember this. If there's nothing you heard me so far, remember this one line. Life is always measured by how you used your time. Not how much of time, but how you used it. Right? And I think there was a period in my life where I could have used my time much better. That is a little disappointing, but it's not a failure. I still learned from that phase. That's what I'd say.
Okay. The next question is also asked by Hamdan. Which thing you considered as successful in your life?
Again, I wouldn't say successful. I'll say what do I enjoy the most. I think the last 3 years of my life have been when I decided to pursue my purpose, right? Have been the most satisfying passage of my life. I've had the good fortune of holding very high positions in organizations, and I enjoyed it. But this has been the most satisfying, where I was able to stand on my own feet by God's grace. And be a benefit to others. That for me has been the most satisfying.
Okay, sir. The next question is asked by Naran, sir. What is your thought on teachers?
I have great respect for teachers. I think they are the most important people in society. till today, and Abdul will know about the teacher I'm talking about, till today, I meet my 8th standard teacher, Mrs. Satur, till today, right? I'm in touch with her every day because she was a teacher who believed in me when I did not believe in myself. She was somebody who believed in me when people around me did not believe in me. And she gave me belief. She made me realize that I have potential, right? I didn't believe in myself, but she made me believe. So I think teachers are the most important profession in society. And I think, unfortunately, they're getting more respect than what they are getting today. Okay, so teachers right up there, farmers right up there, soldiers right up there. That's the way I look at it when I look at society and people who add value in society. And doctors also.
Okay, so next question is asked by Masood Nawaz. How can we get success in life?
I think I answered that, Mutahir. Have a right attitude, have a right goal, believe in yourself, don't give up. That would be my advice on that. Focus.
Okay, so next question is asked by Yas. What is the idea to become a good personality?
I think being honest to yourself, developing good character. Character is who you are when nobody is watching you. That is what character is. Character is being true to yourself. And somebody who keeps up their word. If you say something I'll do, you will do it. Right? If you are a person of your word, then people will respect you, people will take you seriously. Right? So I think these are the qualities of a great personality. And remember what I told you earlier, personality is within. It's not how you look and dress and all that stuff. Right? You have to dress right. You have to be hygienic. All those things are important. But the critical part is who you are within you.
Okay, so the next question is asked by Sath. What was your childhood aim?
Sorry, what was your?
Childhood aim.
Childhood aim. Oh, I had many aims. It kept changing. First, I wanted to play cricket for India. That was my childhood aim. Then I realized it's not going to happen. Then I wanted to be an engineer sometime, and that didn't happen, right? But finally, I realized I wanted to be a good leader, okay? And that somehow stuck with me. So therefore, I at work, I grew up to lead large teams. That helped. But I think what I'm doing right now is to work to develop other leaders is something that really was a goal, I think, which is becoming a reality now.
Next is asked by Asif, how we can overcome our failures?
Learn from them, Tayo. Learn from your failures. Remember, failure is just a learning opportunity. And in a sense, celebrate your failures. Because that means you've tried something big and it's not worked out. Many people have not tried anything. And for me, they are the real failures. Because they chose not to try. They never failed. But that's a big sign of failure. If you've tried something, it's not come out the way you expected, that's fine. No problem. So learn from it is what I'll say.
Okay, so next question is asked by Salman. How to maintain time management?
If you fail to plan, that means you're planning to fail. If you fail to plan, it means you're planning. You must have a plan. Okay, how are you going to spend your time? And you make activities are creating value. Right? If I spend much of time in activity right now, it's going to create so much of value. If you're on 10 steps, a big chunk of my time is going to go for space. Right? Then there's a chunk of time that's going to go for my exercise. There's a chunk of my time going to go into hobbies. There's a chunk of my time going to go in terms of reading good literature, right? Or watching good programs like on TED Talks and things like that. So you plan it out and you write it down and then you see
every time you complete a particular activity, you take it off. That's what I would do.
Okay, so next was asked by Muhammad Furqan. Question when it is. Sir, once again. This question is asked by Muhammad Furqan. Some situation when you fail and overcome to succeed, what made you to succeed?
Learning from what went wrong, being willing to. Being honest to accept your mistakes, speaking to others who can help you, who also need it, get their perspective. So having the right set of people and having an attitude to learn. Okay, I think that's very important. You must have an attitude to learn. The moment you stop to learn is the day you stop to earn. Right? The earning depends upon your learning. And if you're not learning, you can't earn. Right, so I think these are some factors I think which are very, very important in the pursuit of success.
Okay, so next question is asked by Umar. What is the biggest factor that helped you to be a successful one?
I think it's belief. You got to believe in yourself. You got to believe in your strengths. You got to believe that you can do it. So I think that's very important because many others are not going to believe in you. You need to be believing. There's a nice proverb which says, all things are possible to him who believes. All things are possible to him who believes. So if your belief is small, your achievement will be small. If your belief is large, your achievement will be large. According to your size of the belief will be the size of your achievement. So belief, I think, is key.
Okay. Next question is asked by Ubada. Which lifetime made you success?
Which what? Sorry?
Which lifetime made you success?
Which, tell me, I might be able to understand the question really.
Asking during which time you feel as a successful person, successful one?
It's difficult to answer. In every stage, because you define success differently. So the definition of success now in this stage is by how many people have I been able to inspire? Okay, that's my definition. If you had asked me 5 years ago, my definition of success would have been, have I met my business goal? Have I met my sales target? If I target, then I'd say I'm successful, right? If you asked me a few years ago before that, then I would have answered it differently. So depending upon the stage in life, you have a specific definition of success. So, and therefore you define your success.
Okay, so next question is asked by Musab. How you were motivated during school life and now what keeps you motivated?
What keeps me motivated now is my purpose. Once you identify purpose, that's the thing about purpose. Purpose will motivate you every day. When you wake up in the morning, you're excited. Oh, wow, I'm alive now. Because I'm alive, I can do what I'm supposed to be doing, which is to inspire people. Right? So when you have purpose, that motivates you. In the absence of purpose, you have a goal. Okay, I have a goal. I want to lose weight or I want to do this. I want to do that. Whatever your goal is. Your goal motivates you. But the goal is very temporary. Once you achieve the goal is over. But purpose is a continuous process. So when you identify, okay, this is why I think God created me. And because God created me this way, gave me these skills and talents, I think I need to be doing this. Because when I do this, I think God is happy. Somebody said this, right? Your talents are God's gift to you. What you do with your talents is your gift to God. Right? So that's what motivates me.
Okay, so next question is asked by Muhammad Rasif. Which is important, education or character?
Character, definitely. Because I know a lot of people who are very educated, but they live very foolishly. There are educated people who live foolishly. I know a lot of other people who perhaps are not very educated, but they live very wisely because they've got good character. But when you have both, education and character, you're a winner.
Okay. Next question is asked by English Club. Leadership means abroading you.
Leadership means?
Leadership means abroading you.
Abroading you. Yeah.
Yeah.
Leadership means the ability to influence. If you are able to influence another person, and that is leadership. Leadership is not the designation on your card. That's wrong. Leadership is not title. Okay. If I become this position of power, then I am a leader. No, that's not. If you are able to influence somebody, that means you're a leader. Right? And if you ask me who are the greatest leaders, our mothers are the greatest leaders. Okay. Unfortunately, they don't get that exposure or the recognition. But they are the leaders because they are influencing. So my definition of leadership, according to me, is anybody who's willing, who is in a position to influence, is a leader.
Yeah.
I think you have question now. This is your last question. You're like a machine gun, man. You're not stopping.
We will have a last question for the day. We have come to the close of the session. So one question and then we will have the end, inshallah.
Okay, sir. So the next question is asked by Ismail Zabiullah. Sir, if a boy always fails in exam and he is lazy and he is dumb, which can change himself? And can he get achievement, name success? And can motivation change mandatorily?
I think if somebody is continuously failing, you need to understand why is he failing. One, is it a lack of interest or lack of skill? So somebody's got lack of skill, you can always train the person. But if somebody's got a lack of interest, then you need to understand why is he not interested. Right? And you must be able to guide him and say that you need a basic level of education to survive. Right? So you must guide the person. Also, you must find out where are his interests on, right? So once he gets a basic education, where are his interests on? So if you look at Virat Kohli, I think he's just done school. I don't even know whether he's completed school. But today he's a very successful player because he's interested in cricket. So he's got his basic level of education and then he's focused in his area of interest, right? So I think it's important to get a basic level of education and then focus on your area of interest. But without a basic level of education, in today's world, it's very difficult to survive, right? And I always tell people, it's better to choose the path of pain today to get the path of gain tomorrow. But if you want to live a very comfortable life today, then you'll have a pain tomorrow. So it's better to go through the pain today to get the gain tomorrow, right? Thank you.
Thank you, Rajiv. We have the very good question which is coming in the last, because something connected to the lockdown. What skills should we cultivate in this lockdown to help us in the distant future? So, very important.
So, I think you have to do what you're supposed to do, which is if you are in 10th standard, you have to study what you have to study. But besides that, pick up other skills, right? Pick up skills. There are lots of courses that are available, right, online. So go to the online internet and pick up those courses. If you're interested in photography, pick up a skill on photography. If you're interested in to know more about digital marketing, understand what digital marketing is. Nothing stops you to do that, right? If you're interested in making videos, make the videos. If you're interested in, on any other skill, on creative skills, learn the creative skills. So do what you're supposed to be doing, which is studying, but use your free time to pick up skills. And today on the internet, there's so many skills available, right? Go and pick up a few skills. It's important.
Okay, Rajiv. Thank you so much. Mutahir, let's finish the session with a vote of thanks.
Okay, sir. Now we have vote of thanks by Muhammad Salman of 12th C.
Assalamu alaikum to everyone who have gathered on this occasion. It's my privilege to have been asked It's my privilege to have been asked to propose a vote of thanks on this occasion. I, on behalf of KH Metric, Boys Higher Secondary School, and the entire fraternity of the institution, first of all, extend my most sincere thanks to the Almighty for the success of this event, and extend a hearty vote of thanks to the chief guest who spared time from his busy schedule to grace his.
No problem. Fine. You lost me.
Okay, fine. Mutahir, you can conclude with Rajiv, sir, with thanks.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir, for your motivational speeches and thanks for answering our questions, sir. We are really impressed with your answers and hope we get another opportunity to meet you, sir.
Thank you. You did a good job too.
For coming. Thank you so much. Bye.